Dear civil engineers, in our previous lecture, I have shown you that how we'll create that grid line. So in this lecture, I'm just going to show that how we'll draw our model. Okay. So if you're new here, you can watch our previous lecture. That link are given in description. So first of all, we'll create model, and you know that we have defined everything what we need to create that structure. So I'll just click here, okay, and from here I'll select RC column and which section of column you need you have to select. So I'll select C1 12 into 12 inch for every corner, and from here I'll just come here where I will create our column. So I will create our column from ground floor to base, then I will create from street 1 to GF. Clear? So to do that, I'll just click ground floor. When I'm here, now what about the height actually? So total height will be 6 feet. So you can see here down minus Z. That means our in downward direction, so that will be 6. And after giving here value 6, you have to click here in that box. After that, just come here where you want to create. So in that corner, I'll give one of our column in that corner one. After that, here one, and here another one. Okay. So when it's done, now I'll create that column 12 into 15. Okay, 12 into 15. So in that side, I'll just give it. And if you see, or that column direction are in that direction. Okay, so in that direction. Clear? So this is suitable for that one and that one. But for that side, I'll use column orientation with 90 degree. So I'll just close that. And I'll select them like that, and I'll go here, edit, from here, here rotation. Okay, I'll select that middle point of it and come in that direction, here or in that direction, it's up to you actually in which direction you want to create. So I prefer that our that rotation will be 90 degree. Okay, so what we'll do actually, I'll just put value here, or if you need that, then you can change it. So just simply click here. Okay, after that you will see it's a changed little bit, but I do not do that. So I'll take it again, I'll click a rotation and I'll click middle point of it. Okay, and here I'll just give 90 degree, then enter. Okay, just see it's a changed, its orientation have been changed. So I'll close. Now I'll copy of it. So I'll select or skip. After that I'll select. Then they have many options, move or copy. So I'll use copy of it. So I'll click here copy and I'll select middle point of it. Just see. And after that, I'll move it in that point. Okay. Again. Sorry, I'll skip it. Again, I'll click here. And if I click, we have moved that on, that on. So again, I have to, I'll skip. I'll close that. Then I'll select Again, I'll click remove. Okay, and you can also use drag so that we can do that for multiple time. I'll zoom that. Okay, and from here, I'll move it in that point. Okay, so when it's done, also I can undrag it. I'll just close that. I'll close that. Okay. Now if we see in 3D, just see here a beam have been created. That is unwanted. I'll select and I'll delete that. Okay. And I'll close it and escape for that. And again, I'll go ahead plan. And I'll select and delete it. After that, I'll select that 4. I'll come here in edit. From here, and I'll use that copy option, and I'll click that point. With respect to that point, I'll make a copy. Okay, I'll make a copy here in that point. Just see, all our columns have been moved. I'll close that. I'll close. And again, if we see in 3D, just see, we have done that. I'll just press escape. And after rotating, I'll delete that. Value from here. Again, I'll go plan view. And from plan view, again, I'll go column. And for our middle, I'll select 12 into 18. Okay, and that will be 6. And I'll click here. And I'll come. And I'll create our column. So this column are in that direction. So that column and that column will be in that direction. And our middle column will rotate. So I'll close that. I'll close. I'll escape. After that, I'll select that one. And I'll go here, edit. And from here, I'll just go here, rotation. Okay. And I'll select, I'll zoom it. And I'll select that one. Okay. And I'll just click here. I'll rotate it for 90 degrees. Just see, it's a prorate for 90 degrees. Then I'll skip. Now close that. I'll select. I'll click here, move or copy. I'll take a copy of it. So copy, and I'll select that one, and I'll copy it to here. Just see, we have created all of our columns. I'll close that. I'll close that. Now if I just go here, view, just see, it's done. Okay, so for our, I mean, below our grade beam, all of our column we have created. Now we'll create our beam. Okay, so to create beam, I'll drag and go plan, and I'll just go here, beams, and you know that already we have different some beam sections or arts theme. I'll take grid beam from here. Okay, and that will be horizontal beam, and I'll use that option drag so that I can create continuously. So this is our first point. From here, I'll continuously create our beam, I mean our grid beam. In that point, and here also, again I'll just come that point to that point and that point. Okay, so after that I'll close, skip that, and I'll close. And when it's done, now I'll just skip and select all of them. Okay, by pressing Ctrl, I'll select. Okay, and after that, I'll just go ahead and edit, and I'll take mold or copy. So copy it. And which one I want to move actually, so I'll click here with respect to that point. Okay, or I can skip and I can move that with respect to that point. Okay, so if you click here, just see that one beam have moved, but I need all of them. So what I'll do, I'll just go Ctrl Z. Okay, and I'll close that, skip, and I'll select. That one, also that one, and that one. Okay, and I'll go edit again, and I'll go move, and with respect to that point. I'll move them here on, and again I'll click on that point. Okay, so again we have to select all of them. Okay, so again I'll close that. I'll press Ctrl, or I'll select that one. That one, and that one. After that, again, I'll just go edit. So when everything is okay, I'll take that point as a reference point, and I'll move, and I'll click here. So here, one are missing. I'll simply select that one. I'll go for move, so I'll take that point as a reference point, and here. Okay, so it's done. Now I'll close that. Again, I'll select that beam, and I'll press Ctrl, and I'll select that beam. Okay, and I'll go move or copy, so I'll use that option drag, so I'll use that copy option. And from here, I'll select that point, and I'll copy it here. Okay, again, I'll copy it here. So this is the I'll close again, and I'll select that one, or I'll select that one by pressing escape. I'll select that beam, and also I'll select that beam, and again I'll go here, move, use drag option, copy, and with respect to that point. I'll go for move, again with respect to that point. So again we have to select. I'll go for select control by pressing control, sorry, I'll select that one. I'll select that one, and after the by pressing control, I'll select also that one. Again, go copy, and here copy with respect to that point. I'll just move it here. I'll zoom it and I'll move it here. Okay. So with respect to that point, I'll move it here also. You can do that randomly, and also with respect to that point, I'll move it here. Just see, it's done. I'll close that, I'll close that. Now I'll go in view. Okay, so you can see that. You can see that, sorry. I'll select, delete. Also I'll delete all of them. Okay, now you can see that we have created our beam. And in this way you have to create the above floor beam. Okay, so now to do that, I'll just go plan view. Now again I will start working. Okay, so first of all, what we'll do actually, first of all, I will apply load here. I'll load in that point, all of that point. Okay, so in our next lecture, I'll just do it that how we'll apply load on our grid beam. I mean, partition or load, and after that, we'll go for our next floor. So, thank you very much. Stay connected till next video.